My name is Nas, and no, I'm not Indonesian, and and yes, we're next to Capitol. I had a tough time growing up. For a couple of years, I thought I was Indian because my friends told me so. So every day I go home, I tell my dad about it, and he's like, "How many times do I have to tell you? You are Malay. It's called a tan." And that's how I lost to my dad in ping pong. Man, I'm sure some of you know that I don't speak Malay very well. When I went to high school, my subject teachers immediately gave up on me. I went to an English-based primary school, so I didn't transition so well. I straight up told the teacher, like, "Jeb, I don't speak Malay." And the teacher's like, "You don't speak Malay? You are Malay and you don't speak Malay? Disgrace!" It's funny that she said that while teaching Malay. In English. And it's, you know, Malay people just don't recognize me as Malay, which is ironic because I blend in pretty well with other races, you know, like, what is that? Kamusta? Sawadika? Hola, ¿qué tal? You don't speak Spanish? You are Spanish and you don't speak Spanish? Disgrace! I blend in with other ethnicities pretty well. But, you know, there was one time where I didn't blend in so well, and it was a concert, my first concert, and it was scary because it was K-pop. Oh, you're laughing now. But here's what scares me: one, you are standing among people who are definitely younger than you, and two, you are the only guy in a mosh pit of hardcore fangirls. When you're a 20-year-old dude, a tan dude, mind you, standing between 13 and 14-year-old pale Chinese girls, you'll stand up like black ink on white paper. I felt like Chris Tucker among hundreds of little Jackie Chans. You know, I've got like facial hair and white hair that you can't see, and it made each different look even worse because from time to time they would ask me, "Uncle, your back okay?" You need something. So, like, I'm 20. I don't need to show that. Like, look at me. My back and knees are okay. How old do you think I am? 32. 32 is not that. It's not that low, right, Dana? and the screaming. I feel like every time they see these dudes, they're possessed. They're like, I was there, so I didn't want to look womanly, so I just said, "Yeah! I immediately regretted it. Everyone starts turning to you, you know? They look at you and you immediately point to your friend and say, "She has a deep voice." And, you know, these girls are so passionate, man. You know, they've got like merchandise, fan pages, fan clubs, that kind of thing. But here's the part that weirds me out, and don't ask me how I know. Anyway, they post up a photo of their favorite idol, right? And it's basically him or her looking at you, pointing at you, and winking at you. And all the comments that these 13 and 14-year-olds say, "Oh my god, I'm pregnant." That's not how pregnancy works! You do not reproduce by winking! I have an O in biology. Man, and there's another weird thing. thing where they do these chants, like at the beginning or like during the song, right? And it's like Ha Young is pretty, Yoo Nun is beautiful, Tae Young is shining, that kind of stuff. it's nowhere else. You can't find it anywhere else. Imagine if it was here in a comedy show, like before the MC starts, you know, their like was the Nas is funny, Nas Nani is funny, Kevin Red Horse. I kind of fits. Thank you very much. Alright, that was last, everybody! Alright, we're coming to the last act of the